Yes, please come on in. Yes. Good evening, Gaurav. Please take your seat.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Gaurav, is it your first interview?
Second, sir.
Second, sir. Second interview, okay. Can you just please introduce yourself to the board?
Sir, I'm Gaurav Garg, originally from Delhi.
Okay.
I did my bachelor's in business studies from Shahid Sukhdev College of Business Studies, Delhi University.
Okay.
I'm currently working in Employees Provident Fund Organization as Assistant Commissioner.
Okay.
My hobbies are reading nonfiction and watching movies.
Okay.
And I enjoy quizzing, sir.
Very good. Do you have any siblings?
Yes, sir. I have three sisters.
Three sisters?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Already you are in a service, well settled. Already you are in a central service, well settled and drawing a good salary.
Yes, sir.
Why do you want to still pursue another service?
Sir, my current service is really good.
Okay.
It's given me an opportunity to work with the poorest sections of the society.
Okay.
Since EPF Act applies to a ceiling of 15,000 rupees a month.
Mm.
But sir, accelerated career progression as well as an opportunity to work in diverse fields is what draws me to civil services, sir.
Okay. Okay, good. So you love IAS,
yes.
Service. How IAS is better or superior to account service?
Sir, it's not a question of superiority, sir. Both services are equally important. Audited account service does plenty of work, which is extremely important from national perspective.
Okay.
Just that the diversity of jobs that IAS offers. I can be a collector of a district one day, heading an industrial enterprise in another time. And I can be working in social sectors in another time. So it's the diversity of the job plus the career progression which makes IAS preferable to other services, sir.
Okay, nice. Recently we heard about the 2G spectrum, sir. Verdict of the court. The court has acquitted the case.
Sir.
There is a propaganda, or be very factual also, that this figure of 1.76 lakh crore rupees is artificially created in order to bring by an personally interested group of people to bring bad name to your group, your political party. Is it possible for a AG to bring out such figures on false pretext?
Sir, I can't comment on whether these are motivated or not, because I'm not privy to those discussions. But I can certainly bring out how those 1.76 lakh figure came about.
Yeah.
Sir, that came about actually because prior to this CAG audit of 2G spectrum allocation, there was an auction of 3G spectrum allocation. And that fetched a figure of 68,000 crore rupees. So what the Honorable Comptroller and the Auditor General did was, he extrapolated that figure. He said 3G is essentially 2.76G. So he extrapolated that figure to 2G spectrum, which was not auctioned in 2008, and arrived at this figure of 1.76 lakh crore rupees.
But is it ethically correct to do that, knowing that this will create unnecessary, you know, impression? And in practice, probably, even if it is auctioned, it could be even 1/100th of this 1.76.
Yes, sir.
He might know, even knowing very well, that this extrapolation technique is not morally a correct story to be revealed. Don't you think it was morally, ethically wrong to do that?
Sir, I would tend to agree with
that.
That's
not real. That's not real, first of all.
That's not real, sir. Actually, the CAG gave three figures, sir. What he gave, 1.76 lakh crore, was just one of the three figures.
Okay.
Another figure was 29,000 crore. This was obtained through from the sale or by which one of the companies which was allotted spectrum gave the figure, sold it to the third company. So he used that figure to extrapolate what would have fetched had it been auctioned. Another was 41,000 crore. So that was also obtained at a price in which another company sold it to a third company. So these were the three figures which CAG gave, sir.
Okay.
I personally feel, sir, that these two figures are much more reliable because they actually gave out what an arm's length transaction involving two unrelated entities would fetch, rather than 1.76 lakh crore, sir. And this, whether it's morally correct or not, I think, sir, the intent of CAG was to bring out the irregularities in the spectrum allocation. So this 1.76 lakh crore, what it did was, it brought out the irregularities, the inconsistencies in the spectrum allocation. It brought the focus onto the efficiencies in the spectrum allocation. And I think the effect was felt off in the next allocation, wherein it was auctioned and it fetched good money, sir.
Okay. Now, in the recent budget, there is a proposal to cover 10 crore people under medical insurance schemes. And practically, will it be possible to bring 10 crore people to the extent of 5 lakhs per person for the next 5 years with the allotment the government has really made?
Sir, from what I have read, it's 2,000 crore has been allocated.
Correct.
That's for the first year, sir. It's a 5-year scheme, so I expect allocations to rise soon. And sir, actually speaking, some of them are already covered. There's a scheme called Rashtriya Swasthya Bima Yojana.
Okay.
Under which many of the unorganized sector workers are already covered by a cover of 30,000. So a cover would rise from 30,000 to 5 lakh, it would rise. So I suppose allocations will rise in coming years. So fiscal challenge is one of the thing. The other would be
2,000 crores for the 5 years allotment.
This is, I suppose, for the first year, sir. So
first year is much less.
First year is much less. I expect it to rise further over the coming years, sir. Once the beneficiaries have been identified, once the allocation, sharing of cost between center and states is worked out, once the nitty-gritties and the modalities of the scheme are worked out, I expect center will raise allocation to it, and I think it will be coverable within the 5 years, sir.
Okay, you are quite positive about it.
Yes, sir, I am, sir.
Even if it is only 40 rupees per person, which company will come forward to give 40 rupees per person for a 5 lakh rupee coverage?
Sir, actually, they will see the coverage. This is just one of the templates. Like, sir, in stock markets, the government, once it invites for disinvestment, it quotes bids, the companies quote bid as low as 1 rupee for the entire IPO. That's because they want to show that they can manage bigger IPOs and attract other customers. So I think that's what the intent of the government is, sir. Once the insurance companies show that they can handle such a scheme.
What will be the approximate insurance cost for 5 lakh rupee per person today in the market?
Sir, sorry, I don't know about this.
It is not less than 12,000 rupees. Okay. Now, okay, sir, me, you can ask.
You are a business graduate.
Yes,
tell me, what is social entrepreneurship?
Social entrepreneurship is basically different from profit entrepreneurship. What it is
which means that you don't make money, you don't make profits in social entrepreneurship?
You may or may not make, sir, but profit is not the primary concern. The primary concern is making difference in the lives of the people working in the social sector. Like SKS Microfinance is a social entrepreneurship.
How is it different from the non-profit organizations?
Sir, social entrepreneurship essentially works on a business model. It may or may not earn profit, but it works on a business model. Proper accounting is there. The firm makes out their return on capital, etc. The profit may or may not be primary objective. While in case of NGOs, the profit is not at all an objective. They're just focused on ensuring that services are good, the services or the objective is achieved. So that is essential difference between social entrepreneurship and NGOs, sir.
Give me other examples other than microfinance.
Microfinance, another example would be, sir, can I just?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, okay, yeah, yes, sir.
Let me draw your attention to the other part, which is the relations, foreign relations. Tell us something about the recent crisis in South China Sea.
South China Sea, sir, that was regarding that verdict that came out.
Yes.
So that verdict, the UN
What is this crisis all about?
So this crisis actually originated post World War II. In the World War II, all the island territories were acquired by Japan. Post World War II, they were liberated. Now, and they became independent nations.
Which were the islands?
Philippines would be one. Then other countries like Vietnam, Malaysia, they were run over by Japanese, sir. So, but China, it claims it has traditional rights over these areas. These islands belong to China. While
Philippines?
The Spratly Islands, sir. Mm-hmm. They were artificially built islands that China has created now. So China claims over that the South China Sea is its sphere of influence. While all these countries, ASEAN countries essentially, they claim that South China Sea it falls within their exclusive economic zone as well as sphere of influence. So this is where the dispute lies, sir. And the recent verdict of the UN court which came out, it said that the China's claim over these, that is the nine dash line, is unwarranted. And these countries have the right over this, territorial waters of these seas, sir.
Do you know the country which filed the case against the claim of China? Whether all the countries of ASEAN claim, or any particular country which claimed?
I think it's with Vietnam, sir.
It was not Vietnam, it was the Philippines.
Thank you.
Anyway, that's one related question. In case, one of your options is also, IFS, right?
Yes, sir.
IFS is number three.
Yes, sir.
Right, in case you are being posted and given a chance of being an ambassador or an high commissioner, what is the difference between ambassador and high commissioner? Is there any difference between ambassador and high commissioner?
Sir, I do remember there is a difference. It's basically a nomenclature difference.
Okay.
It's
what does it mean then? Why you call some countries?
Commonwealth countries.
Countries to Commonwealth were called High Commissioners, while others were ambassadors, sir.
Right, if you are posted as an High Commissioner to Sri Lanka.
Yes, sir.
All right. Or will there be any particular choice of country that you may have, if in case the option is given to you?
Sir,
you
all countries
like,
are good, sir.
Hope you will not go to Afghanistan.
You will not go to Afghanistan.
Will let you go to Afghanistan.
Sir, in serving my country, if I posted in Afghanistan, I would be happy to go. But I would like to go to Latin America, sir. It's highly growing area, it has an expatriate population also, and the similarities are there with India.
Okay.
Further, there is a huge scope to work in Latin America because economic, social cooperation between Latin America and India is still less, and there is huge scope for growth in relations between India and Latin America.
You know the problem in Venezuela, the cryptocurrency issue in Venezuela, have you heard of that?
Cryptocurrency, I haven't heard of it, sir, but I do have heard of the other relationship in the crisis in the political leadership in Venezuela, sir.
Okay, sir, you can ask some questions.
Since you have studied the commerce, sir, could you tell me that in the environmental cost and the ecological, what is this, loss and the economic environmental damage, you will come across one term that is called internalizing the externality. Do you got any idea of what is an internalizing the externality as a commerce graduate?
Sir, it's essentially factoring in the environmental degradation cost, etc. in your calculations for the return on investment. Like, there are many concepts regarding it, sir. There's a concept called economic value added. Social cost benefit analysis, economic value added. These are two terms which factor in this, sir. Social cost benefit analysis is, it converts the environmental degradation cost, etc. In monetary terms, and it factors this into considerations of return on capital, the net present value, internal rate of return, to arrive at the social cost as well as benefit of the given project. This is called internalizing
that
the external.
For the ecological, what about the environment? The disposal cost. Okay, now that you have given your second choice as Indian Police Service. Okay? I'll just ask a very simple question. What is an e-crime?
Sir, any crime which has its origin uses the internet or e-technologies for achieving its aim is e-crime, sir.
List out.
Cyber theft, stealing of information, denying of information.
Term. Stealing of the information, what is the technical term?
It's called hacking. Hacking. So, denial of service attacks, there's cyber terrorism, then there's...
Nigerian cheating? Have you heard this Nigerian cheating? Nigerian cheating. You would be heading information, notification that you won a lottery in London, $50 million. You are going to get,
yes, sir.
Right?
That I have heard, sir.
Okay, this is called
Nigerian
your. They are a group of Nigerian cheating. Okay, madam, you can ask some questions.
Gaurav, you have read two subjects, finance and HR. I was wondering if you are very clear about the current draft that is preparing for new industrial policy. What are the changes that they would like to make compared to the old one?
I'm not aware of exact details, but from what I remember, we intend to make our India manufacturing hub for IT, etc. Because currently our IT ports are pretty high. So 100 billion is the limit that has been set, is the target that has been set for IT and IT related manufacturers, such as mobile phones, etc. As well as we intend to open up many sectors for foreign tie-ups, etc. So these are the things that I remember from the new industrial policy, ma'am.
Okay. Have you heard about the pricing system that the railway ministry is trying to introduce?
Dynamic pricing?
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. This is based on demand pricing, ma'am. For the first 10% of the tickets, the price fare remains constant, ma'am. Post that, it rises with every 1% rise in 1% rise in demand, the fare rises, ma'am. But the maximum fare rise has been capped at 50%, ma'am.
Okay. Then what about your application of HRM? In case you become a bureaucrat tomorrow, you think you can apply your HRM principles there?
Yes, ma'am. Certainly, ma'am.
In what aspects?
Ma'am, first of all, HRM entails breaking down of the human resource function into different parts, such as recruitment, training, selection, appraisal, etc. So in each of these aspects, ma'am, HRM functions can be used to improve civil services. For example, ma'am, recruitment, the questions that are there in the exam, the overall structure of the exam, that can be improved through application of techniques of recruitment. Training programs can be improved. For example, ma'am, in my own training, for EPFO training, ma'am, I personally felt the duration was short. It could have been expanded to cover more concepts, more industrial visits, etc. This is how training can be improved. In terms of performance appraisal, ma'am, new techniques such as MBO, 360 degree appraisal, that can be used to improve the performance evaluation of the civil service, ma'am.
Okay.
These are the ways in which we can use human resource management for.
Okay, Gaurav Garg, your interview has come to a tag end. Best wishes to you.
Thank you.
Yeah, okay. What is your mark last year?
I got 165, sir.
Oh, yeah.
I got 165, sir.
Very less. That is very less for you.
Yes, sir.
Anyway, members will just tell their opinion about you.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
One is here, the body language.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, US,
you know, how are you sitting? Now, okay.
Now it's see, you should correct it. Sit straight comfortably, and then did somebody tell you that you should hold your hands like this?
No, sir.
Because you're trying to hold this, and then, you know, you're doing this kind of a thing.
Okay.
Question. So it was very distracting
squeezing.
For people, squeezing. And then. So you can actually keep it here, and then you can use your hands for gestures.
Right.
Okay. Nothing wrong with it. You don't make wild gesticulations, but you can talk. For example, you're talking about 3 points, 1, 2, 3, you can say that kind of thing. Then that is more natural. Because then also you slump and you're sitting like this.
Yes, sir.
Right?
You understand this? Now again, interview again. You sit properly.
Just come and sit.
Absolutely.
Can you put a chair?
Yeah.
Let's see. Yeah.
Leave the mic out. We don't want that. Yeah. Incidentally, they won't give any mic there. So. Yes. Just come in, and sit down.
So while you're coming, you're having some thought, you're thinking about something.
Yes,
come freely.
You should look at the board and then just slightly awkward. Maybe, are you nervous? You're not nervous, right?
Not really, sir. This is actually my first mock, so a bit of a response is there, sir.
Oh, is it? Okay. Because, you know, the way you walk, you know, so you need to just walk straight and then sit down comfortably. And then no hurry. And then sit down. Now you're better.
Now you can sit.
This is right. So that is the primary thing. And then while looking at people, see, you are always downcast. You're looking at it like this. Maybe you're trying to concentrate on what.
Maybe that's your nature.
So you can actually try to look around. You know? I'm asking questions. You can look at me. You can look at the chairman. Whatever. Right? So make it a point.
You're already looking like an IAS officer. And a very studious IIT guy, like IIT, no? You look like an IIT, what do you call, prototype or?
Studious character.
Oh my, studious character. Yeah, Nikita, you want
to say? I just wanted to add to that some of the positive points. Very, 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 very eloquent, quite
sensitive,
very sensible. That's all very good. You have got to keep it up. That tempo can be retained. But except for, brushing up the current affairs and all that needs to be completely, brushed up and keep abreast of what's happening recently. that's where they're going to concentrate on, I'm sure. And whichever is your area of your comfort zone, you can track the entire conversation and board's attention to that particular point. So that you know your comfort and you track the question will come from one after the other. If I'm going to say ask for some search and I see,
yeah.
That's very confident of for you. Then talk a little more of that so that the next member will also ask them search and
see. He's working in Kadalur. Kadalur.
Yeah, yeah.
So Tamil Nadu people may ask a lot of questions about Kadalur, Neyveli,
yeah,
Robert Clive, Sports St. George.
Yeah, historical aspect of Kadalur and all that, and the recent,
tsunami.
Tsunami,
yeah.
Porto Novo.
All that. These have to be brushed up by you. Okay, you have to expect questions on
that.
But then your communication is quite good and, yeah.
One question
I'm quite happy about it. Problem can't
it. Sir.
Yeah, the same thing only. I am also fully concurring with them. But the only thing we have not, now only I can able to see your face. You are not seeing, and you are also seeing me only. And all the time you are seeing elsewhere, or your thinking is elsewhere. That is the
I think you
are
listening to the question.
Yeah,
and then
absolutely. You listen completely. Yeah. You know the question, you analyze the question, you answered. But you are engaging yourself.
Mm. It's not a written exam, right? So you need to interact with us.
Yeah, so, Gaurav, strictly speaking, I have no opinion to offer. You are doing extremely well. I still wonder how you scored only 160 last year. Probably this body language, something like this. You are always sitting something like this. You'll be wearing a suit, right?
Yes, sir.
It won't be cold there. So, even if it is cold in a suit. Something like this, sit properly and stay, if possible. It may be your nature. I was telling them not to even correct this because probably they may like your posture.
Maybe more a confident look on this.
But all
but
the answers,
you
questions you answered very well.
You have a facelift of your car.
Yeah.
When is the interview, Gaurav?
You got the plus point. He's from Delhi.
Delhi
yeah.
also. And when is the interview?
Eighth March.
He's from Delhi. Eighth March, sir.
That army camp area.
Cantonment.
Kutubinar.
Study center
was also there.
Badra
Hospital.
This is near the
IAFT.
What's your father? Garg?
He's a businessman, sir. He's a real estate broker.
Okay. So
Garg is from Kashmir? UP.
Any crime committed with the use of computer is cybercrime. Yeah, we will answer that. Various kinds of crimes, we can say all kind of cheating can be committed with the help of this computer. But the method used may be computer virus, computer worm, Trojan, botnet.
Actually, sir, I just wanted to start. Trojan was I was coming up, but suddenly it was slipping out of my mind.
Yeah, phishing is a method. These are methods. Ultimately, people can cheat, or blackmail, or try to defame people. When they can commit murder also. In the sense, engage people. Yeah, it can be used. Computer can be used in the process of committing crimes, like robbery, theft, murder. Even murder again. Yeah, again. Hire money and transfer money to somebody. He can kill people.
Again, the social entrepreneurship. Is actually not about. See, you said social entrepreneurship. We want to make money. So all social entrepreneurship entrepreneurs want to make money. They have this concept of doing good while doing well. That's really right. So unlike for-profit organizations, these are all the for-profit. Unlike regular business, you have a social cause. For example, I ask you examples other than microfinance. You talk about clean tech. Those kind of things. There are a lot of high technology, providing water to everyone, improving healthcare. There are a lot of other areas other than microfinance. Microfinance is the most common. There are a lot of other areas now coming up.
Narayan Hridayalaya, can we say, sir, is a social entrepreneurship venture?
Come again?
Narayan Hridayalaya, the Devi Shetty venture.
Yeah, you can say that. See, he's making, he's not doing it free, but he's doing it at a very low cost. But it's still, he has to make money. Unlike non-profit organizations, where they have to go and beg for money. You don't have to do that here, right? I mean, you can plow back the profits into this. Yeah.
Okay. All the best to you.
All the best.
Yeah.
Can you say any kind of problem, my answers, with respect to my answers, factually were they all correct, sir?
Actually, possibly correct, but the way you answered, the way you understood, everything is absolutely okay.
Many other
actual
times,
things.
And
yeah,
also, you have to do something about your, you have a nasal problem, block.
Currently, it's served by allergy actually.
Nasal block.
Yeah.
Sounding
nasal.
Okay.
Now, only with reference to the cast, you have to include that the environmental disposal cost also. Suppose I am purchasing this one, means a plastic one, means then I am the consumer. But that disposal cost I am not paying.
Okay.
It is paid from the taxpayer's money.
Okay.
So the person who has used the thing has to pay the disposal cost also.
Okay.
That is called the internalizing, the externality.
Okay.
Okay?
Thank you.
Yeah, okay.